In 7B exercise, few sums are same. So I'll be doing one-one sums from there as a division. And if see question number one and question number two is same, so let's do the question number one. Then here question number five and six are same, 8 and 9 is same. So I'll be doing one-one sum from there. This will help you in revision. You have all the sums solved with you. We have done that solving before. So keep the solution also, that old notebook where you have solved all the sums step by step. Keep that book handy and keep referring to that book, because all the steps which we have done are done properly in the book which you had attended the live lecture. Okay. So the first question. A man bought a certain number of oranges, out of which 13% were found to be rotten. So this sum, in this type of sums, we first take the value, the unknown value as 100. So here we don't know the number of oranges. So we'll take, let the number of oranges be 100. Okay, so here we'll start the question with, let the number of oranges bought be 100. Now, the question says, out of which 13% were found to be rotten. So 13% of this 100 are found to be rotten. So 13% means how much? 13% of 100 is 13 oranges. So 13 oranges are rotten. Okay, and how many oranges are left now? 100 minus 13, that is 87 oranges are left. Okay. Now, then what he's saying, he gave 75% of the remaining in charity. 75% of the remaining in charity. So out of these 85 oranges, 75% were given in charity. So 75% means how much? 75% of 87. 75% of 87. Do this calculation. What do you get? Multiply 87 into 75. You will get 6585 upon 100. 6525. 6525 upon 100 means it will be 65.25. So that means how many oranges are given in charity? 65.25 oranges are given in charity. So oranges remaining. How many oranges are remaining after charity? See, first 13 oranges chale gaye because they were rotten. Okay, remaining 87 missing. 65.25 oranges are gone in charity, because in the question it was told, it was clearly mentioned that 75% of the remaining are given in charity. Okay, so the oranges remaining is 87 minus 65.25. Do this calculation. You will get 21.75 oranges remaining. Okay, Why am I getting the answer in decimals? Because I have taken the number of oranges as 100. Okay. And I am getting how many oranges are remaining? 21.75. Oranges are remaining. In the question, it is said he still has 522 oranges left. 522 oranges are left. Still 522 oranges. Means, see, जब मैंने number of oranges को 100 लिया, 100 लिया, तो how many oranges are left? 21.75. Okay, if total number of oranges are 100, oranges left are 21.75. Okay, so how many oranges must be brought so that the oranges left are 520? So the oranges left are 522. जब 100 oranges लिए थे, तो remaining कितना था? 21.75. तो अगर कितने oranges लेंगे, so that the remaining oranges are 522. Now cross multiply this. You will have to cross multiply this. Shift this point, remove this point and add 100 here. Remove this point. Do the calculation. Tell me what answer you are getting. Yes, correct. Correct. No case. Your answer is wrong. Others have given proper answer. The answer should be 2400. The number of oranges brought will be 2400. Case 6000 is wrong. See the calculation. If you want, I'll do the calculation here. I'll show you what the calculation is. First, we remove the decimal and you add 100 here. Okay. Correct, Shrey. After adding 100, cancel with 25. Cancel the number with 25. So 25, 8 and 7. 25, 4. Then 87 into 6, I think. 8, 7, 6 are 42, 4. 8, 6 are 48, 522. So 1 is 6. 6, 4 is 24 into 100. Equals x. So you will get x as 24. Next, I'll do question number 3 and 4 are a little difficult. Okay. So, first you do the other questions and then come on 3 and 4. Because 3 and 4 may trouble you a little bit. So, first let's do the other questions. Then we'll come on 3 and 4. So, let's do the fifth question first. A's income is 25% more than B's income. A's income is 25% more than B's income. Find how much percent B's income is less than A's income. Okay, so what we will do here, we will take, see, I always tell you that whichever person comes second in the statement, take them as 100. Okay, so A's income is 25% more than B's income.
So I will think, let the B's income be X.
Sorry,
take 100. Let B's income be 100.
So they are saying A's income is 25% more than B's income.
25% more. So 25% of 100 is 25. So A's income will be 100 plus 25. That is 125. A ki income jo hai, wo 25% zyada hai B ki income se. So I took the income of B as 100. So A's income is 125.
Then find how much percent B's income is less than A's income.
So see, now in the second part, they are saying that how much is B's income less than A's income. So we have to compare it with A. A ka income agar 125 hai, to B ka income 100 hai. Means kitna kam hai income difference. The difference here is 125 minus 100, that is 25. Okay, but we have to find the percentage. Okay, and we have to compare it with A. Ki B ki jo income hai,
the B's income is how much less than A's income. So A se compare karna hai.
We have to find the percentage. So that is whatever difference you get upon A's income into 100. Find this percentage.
Always remember, first you take 100, then you find the income of other person, okay, and then whatever information is given, you will find the percentage for that. The difference is 25, so 25 upon A's income,
because pucha hai ki A ki comparison mein kitna. So this, yes, you will get the answer as 20%.
Now try to do the sixth question on your own. Try the sixth question on your own. Come on. Mona is 20% younger than Neetu. So take the
Neetu's age as 100. Take Neetu's age as 100. And try to solve this up.
Come on, fast. If you are getting confused, I'll explain you. Mona is 20% younger than Neetu.
So 20% of 100 is 20. So Mona is younger, means less. So Mona's age will be 100 minus 20, that is 80. Mona's age will be 80 because she is younger. मतलब कुछ छोटी है. कितना छोटी है? 20% less. So if Bibu's age is 100, Mona's age will be 80. Okay. Now what they are asking? By how much percent is Neetu older than Mona? So we have to compare the difference with Mona's age. Okay, we have to compare the difference with Mona's age. So difference here is 100 minus 80, that is 20. Okay, and percent change, the change in percentage is whatever is the difference upon this second age which you get. Second age, Mona's age is 80. 20 upon 80 into 100. See, focus on the A and B exercise first. Practice them first. If you are comfortable with the A and B exercise, only then do the C exercise. You will get the answer as 25%. Correct. Yes. Sure. Shanaya. Correct. Pari. See, exercise, it depends on you. Okay. If you are comfortable with the chapter, do the C exercise also. If you are finding it difficult, then do the MB exercise. Yes, you can do the solved examples. Do practice the solved examples, which are similar to the exercise A and B. Practice those solved examples. It is good because in school also, many times it happens that teachers give questions from the solved examples. So it is better to do the solved examples. Let's practice the seventh sum now. Read the seventh question. Let the price of sugar, if the price of sugar is increased by 25%, okay? If the price of sugar is increased by 25% today, by what percent should it be decreased tomorrow to bring back to the original price? So, see, we don't know the price today, so let the price be 100. Now it is increased by 25%. Okay, the price is increased by 25%. So 25% of 100 is 25 rupees. Okay, put the rupees sign also. So price of the sugar will be 100. So 25% increase, that means the new price is 100 plus 25, that is 125. New price is 125. 20 after 25% increase. Now they are saying, by what percent should it be decreased? After increasing, after making it 125, after 125, by how much percent should we decrease it to bring back to the original price, that is 100? So means again you have to reduce. So
reduction, or you can say the change in price. So the price should reduce by 25, okay? Now 25, and which price should reduce? This 125 will reduce, okay? So we have to compare this 25, find the percentage of this 25 with 125.
So 25 upon 125 into 100. So 1s are 5s are, you should get the answer as 20%.
So the price should decrease by 20% to bring back to the original price. Next question, number 8. Correct, Shaurya. Question number 8, next. A number is increased by 15%, becomes 391. A number increased by 15% becomes 391. See, in question number 8, question number 9, they have given the value of that number. कि नंबर इंक्रीज होने के बाद कितना बन जाता है 391, ओके? सो व्हाट वी विल डू हियर, अगेन वी कैन सॉल्व दिस सम बाय टेकिंग 100 आल्सो एंड टेकिंग x आल्सो, बट आई विल डू द इजीियर वन व्हिच एवर इज इजी. सो जस्ट चेक प्रीवियसली इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर. Did we solve this sum by taking x or by taking 100? Just check. I think we solved it by taking x. Yes, because for this sum x becomes easy. See, I'll explain you how. A number increased by 15% becomes 391. So see, let the number be x. Let the number be x, okay? After increasing the number by 15%,
increasing the number by 15% means what will the increased number be? How to find the increased number? The original number plus 15% of the original number.
15% increase होने का मतलब क्या है? ओरिजिनल नंबर x है, ठीक है, और उसमें वी हैव एडेड 15%, 15% ऑफ x. सो ओरिजिनल नंबर प्लस 15% ऑफ x. सो आई टेक द LCM. So we took the number as x, we increased the number by 15%. So the number became 115x upon 100. Okay. Now the answer they are saying the question, the increased number is 391. So write 391 here.
391 equals 115x upon 100. Cross multiply, you will get the answer. Tell me what answer you get.
340, correct.
See, I'll also explain you how to solve this sum using 100. Just copy this first.
See, I'll also explain you how to do the sum using 100. So let the number be 100. The number is increased by 15%. So 15% means how much? 1500 will cancel. So increased by 15% means 100 plus 15, that is 115. This is the increased number.
115. Then you have to do unitary method. That 100 increase hoke kitna ban gaya? 115 ban gaya. So which number will increase and become 391? Again, unitary method. 100 jo humne agar 100 liya tha, wo increase hoke 115 ban gaya. 15% increase ke baad. Okay. So which original number will increase and become 391? Cross multiply 100 into 391 equals 115 into x. This 115 will come down. So again, same thing you get. 100 into 391 upon 115 is x.
You can solve this. Whichever method you find easy, I have taught you both the methods. You can follow anyone. Copy this also if you want.
Two numbers are respectively 20% and 50% more than the third number.
See, we'll revise exercise 7C also, okay? But not today. Today you focus on 7A and 7B, and you can do some easy sums if you want from 7C, not all, only a few easy similar sums which are similar to A and B. 7C, later on, if you want, I'll practice again with you. We can do quickly 7C. I'll send you the solution also of 7C. You can refer that. Focus on 7A and B only first. Now, in tomorrow's test, I won't give you sums from 7C. Don't worry. Later on, we'll do it. Two numbers are respectively 20% and 50% more than the third number.
So, see, what we will do, let the third number be x.
let the third number be 100.
So the two numbers are respectively 20% and 50% more than the third number.
So the first number is 20% more. So the first number is 20% more than 100. So 20% first number is 20% of 100. That is 20.
Sorry for the disturbance.
The first number is 20% more. So 20% more means first number is 20% more means 20% is 20. So first number will be 100 plus 20. That is 120. The third number is 100. And they are saying the first number is 20% more than the third number. So 20% more means this first number is 120. The second number is, in the question it is said, the second number is 50% more than the third number. So 50% kitna hota hai? 50% is 50% of 100 is 50. Okay. So the third number will be 100 plus 50, that is 150. Third number is 100. The second number, the first number is 20% more, means 120. The second number is 50% more, means 150.
Okay, now we have all three numbers. Now they are asking me, understand properly, they are asking me, what percent is the second of the first? What percent is the second of the first? Second of the first, matlab second ko upar likhna hai.
फर्स्ट को नीचे लिखना है और इसका परसेंटेज फाइंड करना है. व्हाट परसेंटेज सेकंड ऑफ द फर्स्ट. तो कभी भी जब ऐसा पूछते हैं ना तो जो नंबर पहले बोला है सेकंड ऑफ द फर्स्ट, सेकंड को ऊपर लिखो, फर्स्ट को नीचे एंड मल्टीप्लाई बाय 100. सी व्हाट आंसर यू गेट हियर.
Your answer should be 125%.
In this question, they had told that the first and second number are 20% more than the third number. So, इसलिए वो 120 हो गया और 150 हो गया. But 11th question में थोड़ा सा change किया उन्होंने.
They have changed the question. 11th.
Two numbers are respectively 20% and 50% of the third number. मोर देन नहीं बोला है, उन्होंने बोला है 11th क्वेश्चन में दैट टू नंबर्स आर 20% एंड 50% ऑफ द थर्ड नंबर, मतलब सिर्फ 20% है और सिर्फ 50% है ऑफ द थर्ड नंबर,
मतलब लेट द थर्ड नंबर बी 100 okay, so the first number will be 20% of the third number means 20,
add nahi karna hai usko wapas, bas ye 20 hi aapka answer hai,
first number is 20, first number is 20% and second number is 50%, 50% of 100 is 50. So first number is 20, second number is 50.
यहाँ पे देखो, यहाँ पे हमने क्या किया था, 20 को 100 में ऐड किया था. क्यों ऐड किया था? Understand the difference. Question में बोला था कि the first number is 20% more than the third number. More word use किया था. तो हमने number के अंदर 20 को ऐड किया. But यहाँ पे ऐसा नहीं बोला. यहाँ पे is only said that the first number is 20% of the third number. So 20% find value of the third number. Now they are asking me find the percentage of the second to the first.
The second to the first ka percentage. So 50 upon 20 into 100.
What answer you are getting?
250%, right?
Correct. Twelfth question. Again same, but this time they have not told more than. This time they have said less than. जब more than होता है तो we add और less than है तो we will subtract. Okay, very simple. So two numbers are respectively 30% and 40% less than the third number.
So let the third number be 100. So the first number is 30% less. First number 30% means how much? 30% means 30. Okay, so less means subtract 30 from 100. You will get 70. So this is the first number, 70, because it is 30% less than the third number. Second number is 40% less. 40% means how much? 40% is 40. So 100 minus 40, it is 60. So the first number is 70, second number is 60.
The question is, what is the percentage of
second to the first? Second to the first percentage. So 60 upon 70 into 100. You will get the values in fraction.
Correct. 85, 5 upon 7. Answer will be 85, 5 upon 7. Now,
let's do the third question.
We have solved the almost entire exercise.
Fourth question. Let's solve the fourth question.
Third and fourth are almost the same. See, in a combined test in maths and chemistry, 84% candidates passed in maths.
So, see, 84% passed in maths means how many failed in maths? So, percentage failed in maths. How many will fail in maths? 100 minus 84. That is 16% failed in maths.
Okay. Then they are saying 76% passed in chemistry.
So percentage failed in chemistry. We want failed percentage. 100 minus 76. That is
24% failed in chemistry. Why I am finding failed percentage? Because if you see further, they have said 8% failed in both. जो both के लिए जो भी information देते हैं ना, ठीक है? Both में अगर information दिया है failed का, कि 8% failed in both, तो दोनों information failed के लिए find करनी पड़ेगी. अगर ऐसे दिया होता question में 8% passed in both, तो दोनों information passed की use करते हैं percentage. ठीक है? तो both में जो भी information दिया है, you should bring your question in that form. तो यहाँ पे बोला है 8% failed in both. ओके सो इसलिए मैंने फेल्ड का परसेंटेज निकाला है. फेल्ड का परसेंटेज सो इट इज लाइक दिस. सी इफ आई मेक अ पाई चार्ट इट इज लाइक दिस. फेल्ड इन मैथ्स हाउ मेनी पीपल फेल्ड इन मैथ्स. सो 16% फेल्ड इन मैथ्स, 24% फेल्ड इन केमिस्ट्री एंड 8% फेल्ड इन बोथ. दिस इज मैथ्स एंड दिस इज केमिस्ट्री. Okay, now they are asking me what is the percentage of failed candidates. Okay, so see 16% failed in maths. मतलब ये जो पूरा circle है ना, this is 16%. This full circle. Okay. So 16% में ये 8% भी included है. 8% लोग ऐसे हैं जो दोनों में fail हुए हैं. तो उनका काउंटिंग मैथ्स में भी हो रहा है और उनका काउंटिंग केमिस्ट्री में भी हो रहा है. मतलब उनका काउंटिंग दो बार हो रहा है. डबल टाइम दे हैव बीन काउंटेड. ओके सो व्हाट आई विल डू इज आई विल फाइंड हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स फेल्ड इन मैथ्स ओनली एंड हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स फेल्ड इन केमिस्ट्री ओनली. ओके सो आई विल राइट इट हियर.
परसेंटेज स्टूडेंट्स failed in maths only. Percentage students failed in maths only. Tell me what will be the answer.
Percentage students who failed in maths only. So ये पूरा 16% है. इसमें से ये 8% को निकाल दो. Because ये 8% both वाले थे. 8 को निकाल दो 16 में से. So you will get 16 minus 8, 8%. 8%. So student number of students failed in maths only is 16 minus 8, 8%.
पाई चार्ट से समझना है तो ऐसे समझो. पाई चार्ट में देखो तीन पार्ट्स. दिस इज वन पार्ट ऑफ पाई चार्ट. ये इतना, ये एक पार्ट है, ये इतना जो सिर्फ मैथ्स का है. ये जो बीच का पार्ट है ये कॉमन है. और ये जो थर्ड पार्ट है दिस इज ओनली केमिस्ट्री. ओके, सो ओनली मैथ्स बोथ एंड ओनली केमिस्ट्री. थ्री पार्ट्स है पाई चार्ट के. नाउ परसेंटेज स्टूडेंट्स फेल्ड इन केमिस्ट्री ओनली. तो कैसे पता चलेगा केमिस्ट्री ओनली? ये पूरा केमिस्ट्री का 24 है माइनस बोथ, सो दैट इज 16%. यू विल गेट 16%. कॉपी दिस. Okay, now the question is find the percentage of failed students, failed candidates. Find the percentage of failed candidates. So failed candidates ke liye total failed candidates, total percentage of failed will be how much? Maths mein kitne fail hue? 8%. Chemistry mein kitne fail hue? 16%. एंड दोनों में कितने फेल हुए? 8%. सो टोटल कितना मिलेगा आपको? 32% फेल. So total 32% failed. So how many passed? Total percentage of passed candidates. 32% fail हो गए तो pass कितने हुए? 100 minus 32, that is 68% passed. So in the second question, they are asking me if 340 candidates passed in the test, then how many candidates had appeared in the test? So total कितने बच्चे appeared हुए थे? उन्होंने पूछा है, and they have said that 340 have passed. Okay, मतलब the question is कि स्टूडेंट पास हुए थे. दिस 68% इज नथिंग बट 340 कैंडिडेट्स. 68% इज नथिंग बट 340 कैंडिडेट्स. ओके, जो पास है ये 68% पास है एंड दैट इज 340. तो टोटल कैंडिडेट्स मतलब 100% कैंडिडेट्स कितने होंगे? 68% अगर 340 है तो 100% कितना होगा? यू हैव टू फाइंड दैट. क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई. 68 into x equals 100 into 340. So you will get the answer as 500 candidates were there in the test.
Okay, so we have completed the revision of 7D. Sorry. I am giving you one question.
You have to solve that question on your own.
I am giving you one question.
Solve this question. A number increased by 20% becomes 1920. Find the number. Do it on your own.
Yes, correct. So the answer is 1600. Answer will be 1600.
You can take the original number as X. Okay, and then increase the number by 20%. Increase the number by 20% is 20% of x. So you will get 120x upon 100.
And this will be equal to 1920. You will get the answer.
So we have completed 7B. 7C, I told you that we will do it later. I'll keep one lecture, and in that lecture we'll practice 7B only. Okay. When some easy test is there, that time I'll revise 7C. Okay. Now see, profit and loss was a little complicated chapter, so that is why I kept the revision lecture also. Otherwise, not all the chapters require revision, because few chapters are very easy. Okay. And I have also sent a new schedule of test where I have included science test. Just a second, I'll stop the recording because the lecture is done.